Welcome back to the weekly show, Occidental College. I am your host, Mason Atkins, and in keeping with last week's theme of unconventional ways for people to kill you, we're going to go right into this week's new way of somebody trying to kill you indirectly. Caltrans. If any of you are familiar with the misery they cause Californians, they are responsible for any kind of freeway construction you see at 2 in the morning, because that's when it's safest to put construction workers out on freeways when nobody's on them. So that makes sense. What doesn't make sense is the 710-210 connector tunnel. The 710 freeway runs up until you get to South Pasadena, then it stops. You have to go on various side roads and residential roads in order to continue making your way to the 210 freeway, which, if we're all familiar with our local geography, the 210 freeway and the 134 freeways are the freeways just up the road. If you get on Eagle Rock Boulevard, hang a left on Colorado Boulevard, and then proceed to the freeways. 210 goes east, the 134 goes west, 210 also goes north, but nothing goes south. That's where the 710 comes in. So how do they do this? Well, it'll be a 5-mile-long tunnel under the city of Pasadena, and it's expected to cost $5.4 billion. You might think, yeah, this is a great idea, until you actually see what it's going to look like. So we have a map of the route up right now, but the actual structure of this tunnel is going to begin in a rectangular quadrant. So you have the tunnel, and then it's going to be divided into fourths, separated probably by concrete. And on one side, you'll have the northbound traffic, and on the other side, you'll have the southbound traffic. And then eventually, that'll split off into two actual, like, tubular tunnels, to borrow vernacular from my surfing friends, where it'll be double-decker traffic, northbound in one tunnel, southbound in the other tunnel. Like, yeah, no, that seems like a pretty good idea. Until you think about what happens a lot in California. Car accidents. People not from California like to say Californians are terrible drivers, especially when it rains. Luckily, it doesn't rain in California anymore. But when car accidents of a particular magnitude happen, fire department and police and paramedics tend to use the opposite direction traffic to get to the accident. They can't do that here. And to make matters worse, the freeways that go underground are only going to be 2 lanes wide, as opposed to the usual 4 to 5 that you see above ground, which is going to make it even more difficult for emergency vehicles to get underground to save you if you get into a giant car wreck and things start catching on fire. So yeah, why does Caltrans think this underground death trap is a good idea? Well, proponents think that by finishing the 710-210 connector and sending it right underground, those people won't be driving above ground where the rest of us are. So during those peak rush hour driving times, so, you know, 4:30 to 7:30 when you're trying to come back from Target or whatever, drive, you went off campus for dinner, and all of a sudden you're like, where'd all these people come from? Well, they would be underneath you driving home. Except there are only 2 ways to get in and out of the tunnel. So if any of these people live in Pasadena, they're not going to take the tunnel anyway because they have to drive to the side roads in order to stay in Pasadena once they leave the tunnel. There are only 2 ways to get in and out. At the what will eventually become the 710-210 connector part, which is up where we are, or where the 710 actually just goes underground in South Pasadena. Other than that, you are stuck underground. Godspeed, drivers. That's it for the weekly show. I'm Mason Atkins. We'll see you next week, hopefully with something less likely to kill you.
Nick Dunn, you're probably the most hated man in America right now. Did you kill your wife, Nick?
Everyone told us and told us marriage is hard work. Not for me and Nick.
As you all know, my wife, Amy Elliott Dunn, disappeared 3 days ago.
What's up, everyone? Nick and Tiffany here again, and this week we're reviewing Gone Girl, David Fincher's newest movie. It's doing really well at the box office, actually.
Yeah, I haven't looked at it. How much has it made?
I have no idea, but it's pretty good. Gone Girl deserves it. It's a great movie, I think.
Yeah, David Fincher really outdid himself this time. He's known for making really twisted thrillers that are just, they really blow your mind. This one was about a man who finds his wife missing and goes to the police to try and figure out where she is, and it kind of, the investigation turns against him, and there's this question of whether or not he could have possibly been the person that kidnapped or killed his own wife.
Exactly, like, it takes your mind all over the place, and it's the type of movie where you'll be about halfway through it and you'll think it's over and that, you know, you've seen all of the twists, but then there's the second half of the movie that completely, like, takes it in another direction sideways, and I thought that it was overall just so well done in keeping the audience kind of in this mystery.
Yeah, I think what really helped too was the soundtrack, which was done by the same people that did The Social Network, which is Trent Reznor and Atticus Ross. So I think the weakest point of this movie was really Neil Patrick Harris.
I agree.
I think it's hard to just remove him from his character of Barney Stinson, because 9 Years with How I Met Your Mother kind of gives you a character that you kind of have to play out for a while.
And it doesn't help that he looks exactly the same in this movie as he did as Barney Stinson. He wears a suit, he's super wealthy. Very different character though, but I don't know. He just felt very out of place. Honestly, Tyler Perry did kind of a better job than he did.
Yeah, Tyler Perry was a great character, great cast.
And I feel weird saying that, but
yeah, I really don't like Tyler Perry that much.
Yeah, like, I think Tyler Perry was a really good choice for this movie, so yeah, unexpected surprise.
You ever hear the expression, the simplest answer is often the correct one?
Actually, I've never found that to be true.
So coming up in the next couple weeks, we've got the new Keanu Reeves movie coming out, which so far has been doing pretty well. I think it's got like a 90-something percent.
Yeah, it's called John Wick, and it has a 93% on Rotten Tomatoes right now.
And then we've got Fury that just came out. We have The Book of Life, which is the new Guillermo del Toro movie.
And that has Channing Tatum and I think Zoe Saldana.
Yeah, and it's... it'll be interesting. It's animated, which is different for Del Toro.
I'm gonna show you something beautiful. Everyone screaming for mercy.
So in other movie news, the Avengers Age of Ultron trailer just came out and it looks sweet.
I couldn't really piece it together, but maybe that's the point. What was my favorite part of the trailer was just the song that they used in the background. They took the Pinocchio I've Got No Strings song.
Oh, is that what it was?
Yeah, that's what it was. And they drew it out and got this like really creepy voice to sing it. And it just worked so well for the trailer.
There are no strings on me.
I think that's all the movie news for this time, so we'll catch you in a couple weeks with some new releases and another review.
Laura Kitu. once there were three kings coming back home from school, when all of a sudden they stumble on something that would change their lives forever. Sklenha with the power of knowledge, Colleen with the power of danger, and Marty with the power of heart. And together they are the College Craft Crew.
Welcome back, faithful viewers, to the second episode of College Craft Crew. Yay! Today we will be making crafts in preparation of Arbor Day.
Arbor Day originated in Nebraska City, Nebraska by J. Sterling Morton on Arbor Day. Individuals and groups are encouraged to plant and care for trees.
Wow, Marty, that was actually very informative.
Thanks, I'm really smart and totally didn't copy that directly from Wikipedia or anything.
Our craft for today is going to celebrate the spirit of Arbor Day. We won't actually be planting trees or anything, but instead we will be using paper products to make tree decorations.
My favorite time of year is fall, because that's when the leaves on the trees begin to shrivel and die. Each leaf falls to the ground like dying dreams, only to be crushed by the boots of passerbys.
Okay.
Where did you even get that tree costume, Marty?
It was junior year of high school. I dreamed of taking my talents to the stage, so I auditioned for their production of Midsummer Night's Dream, and I finally got my big break. I was cast as tree number 4. Alas, poor York. I knew him. Horatio!
Actually, Marty, the poor York monologue is from Hamlet, Act 5, Scene 1.
To tree or not to tree? That is the question.
Okay, that's still Hamlet, and that's not even the correct lines. I really don't appreciate you mocking the greatest playwright in the English language.
Look at me, I'm Sarah. I know all about Shakespeare and other shit because I'm super pretentious.
First of all, I do not sound like that. And mock me for my knowledge of theater. I guess 5 years of theatrical training were all just a joke then, right?
Can we just make this craft already? I have to get back to my room so I can watch Gossip Girl. I mean, The Vampire Diaries. I mean, whatever.
It's okay, Colleen. We all know your prickly exterior is just to hide your love for cheesy TV shows.
I will set you on fire.
Let's begin the craft.
What did we make?
I have no idea. Marty?
Look, guys, I had like one midterm this week. I don't have time to do everything. I thought you guys would come up with a craft idea.
Alright.
Tune in next week for another exciting episode of College
Craft.
If we shadows have offended, think but this and all is mended. That you have but slumbered here, while these visions did.
Marty, what the fudge is this?
It's the best I could do on such short notice.
Do I really look like this?